Hey, evolution, why aren't giant pets a thing yet, huh? If dinosaurs grew enough to fill a whole room, why can't I have a big red dog the size of a house? Hey everyone, Lisette here for DNews. Part of what captures our imagination about dinosaurs is just how huge some of them were. The American Museum of Natural History has a cast of a Titanosaur that's so big it doesn't completely fit in the dinosaur wing. The 37-meter-long behemoth's head has to poke out towards the elevators. It's got individual bones bigger than people. The very name of the group of dinosaurs it belongs to has the word Titan in it. But when you start to consider the size of some of these extinct species, it can make you a velociraptor. Why isn't any land animal this huge today, you may wonder? Well, you're not the only one. Lucky for us, paleontologists have been debating the same question, and they've come up with a number of different factors that could explain why some giant reptiles of yesteryear dwarf modern land creatures. It's important to keep in mind that dinosaurs lived a long time ago. No duh, right? But what you may not realize is that before the dinosaurs were wiped out, they were living on a completely different kind of Earth that we live in today. Dinosaurs actually started coming onto the scene about 230 million years before present. During their existence, CO2 levels were all over the place. Estimates vary, but for some stretches, there could have been 3 to 5 times as much carbon dioxide in the atmosphere as there is today. This means the world as a whole was a lot hotter, even up at higher latitudes. And because at the beginning of the Mesozoic era, all land was clumped together in Pangaea, the ocean didn't have as much of a cooling effect on the supercontinent. This would make the planet a more hospitable place for, I don't know, giant cold-blooded reptiles that wouldn't have to waste energy maintaining body heat. See, another reason to worry about global warming. Get out of that SUV and onto a bike unless you want to see T-Rexes in your side view mirror. It may come for you to know that paleontologists aren't all in agreement on the exact amount the atmosphere impacted dinosaur size. It could have had no effect at all, and whether or not dinosaurs were all cold-blooded is even up for debate. Their size could have also been driven by an abundance of food. All that CO2 meant there was likely more vegetation. If there's plentiful vegetation, then large herbivores can thrive. They'd actually benefit from being bigger because longer intestines would be better at breaking down plant matter and extracting its nutrients. Then they could spend less time chewing and more time stuffing grain down their giant gullets. Also, if the herbivores grew larger, then they were harder for predators to take down. Until the predators got bigger. Then the herbivores would get bigger, then the predators would get bigger again. You see, this is where I'm going and it's not good. But there is an upper limit to size because of physical constraints like gravity. Part of the reason whales get so huge is because the ocean supports their weight. On land, a similar sized animal would crush itself without some clever life hacks. Huge dinosaurs like sauropods had lightweight bones compared to mammals because theirs were hollow. Dinosaurs also had another advantage over mammals. When it comes to living large, they laid eggs. If they had to give birth to live young, it would be much harder for them to have large offspring quickly. For instance, elephants have 22-month gestation periods. They can't breed very quickly because live birth is so resource intensive, and it requires a large birth canal. Interestingly, these traits of hollow bones and egg laying have come in handy in a very different way today. They make it possible for the descendants of dinosaurs to fly. That's right, I'm talking about birds. Why they were so big is still a matter of debate, and hopefully we'll find more research out there. But at the moment, they're trying to put together a 100-million-year-old puzzle with a lot of missing pieces. Want to learn more about huge saltwater creatures that are alive today? Don't miss new episodes of River Monsters every Thursday at 9/8 Central on Animal Planet. Seriously though, dinosaurs equal birds. Here's a video all about their gradual shift from ferocious predators to feathered peckers.
Separate research also published in Science last month theorizes that all dinosaurs had feathers. Some were more primitive, like hairs or bristles, while others were soft and downy, like modern birds.
So, are you glad giant reptiles no longer run amok, or would you want a pet raptor? Share your thoughts in the comments, and remember to subscribe to DNews so you never miss an episode. Thanks for watching, guys.